The light is coming through the cornea, then through the aqueous humor, then through the lens, and then through the vitreous. This structure that you see, this is your optic nerve. So the layer that is closest to the choroid here, this layer which contains the cell bodies of the photoreceptors. Where are the synapses? Have a look here. See, these photoreceptors are connecting to these bipolar cells by this synapse. The nerve fiber layer is it contains the axons of these ganglion cells and eventually becomes your optic nerve. Hi everyone. Today, with the help of this 3D model of the retina, we will try to learn how the light is getting transmitted through the retina. So see, if we look at this model, this is the direction of light. So we have to assume that the light is coming through the cornea, then through the aqueous humor, then through the lens, and then through the vitreous. So this is the vitreous. So actually, this is the direction of light, right? So the light is coming in this direction. Now, when the light comes in this direction, it is first sensed by the photoreceptors. So which are your photoreceptors? These are the photoreceptors. So, which are the photoreceptors we have? We have two types of photoreceptors, you know, that is the rods and the cones. So, the light actually has to come straight inside, and at this level, that is at the level of the photoreceptors, the action potential is generated, and then the impulse is transmitted back through the retina. So, see how this is going to happen. So, the light comes in this direction. That is from the vitreous cavity, then the impulse, the action potential is generated in the photoreceptors, and then as I told you, it travels back. So here see, these are the photoreceptor cells. Next to it, we have these cells which are the bipolar cells, and next we have the ganglion cells. So from the photoreceptor cells to the bipolar cells, from the bipolar cells to the ganglion cells. And you can see, make out that the axons of these ganglion cells, what are the axons of these ganglion cells doing? These axons of the ganglion cells are, see, coming here and forming this layer of the retina. So what is this layer of the retina? This is actually the nerve fiber layer of the retina, which is formed by the axons of these ganglion cells. And the axons of the ganglion cells are ultimately becoming the nerve fiber layer, and this continues back posteriorly as your optic nerve. So this structure that you see, this is your optic nerve. So this nerve fiber layer eventually becomes the optic nerve, and the optic nerve ultimately leaves the eyeball by piercing the sclera. So if we look at it now, we understand that the light was actually coming like this here, then the action potential is generated in the photoreceptors. Then from the photoreceptors, it is coming to the bipolar cell, then to the ganglion cell, and then to the nerve fiber layer, and eventually via the optic nerve, it is being transmitted to the brain. So if we were to now look at the layers of the retina, so let's have a look at the layers of the retina now. So whenever we describe the layers of the retina, we describe the layers from outside inwards. So what I mean by outside inwards is, see, this is the sclera, then we have this choroid. So the layer that is closest to the choroid here, this has to be considered the outermost layer of the retina. So see, which is the outermost layer of the retina? It is the retinal pigment epithelium. Next to the retinal pigment epithelium, you can see this part, which is the layer of the photoreceptors. Now, the layer of photoreceptors contains only the outer part of the photoreceptor cells. The cell bodies of the photoreceptors are located here. This layer, which contains the cell bodies of the photoreceptors, this is called as the outer nuclear layer. So, this is the outer nuclear layer, which contains the cell bodies of the photoreceptors. This, which contains the cell bodies of these bipolar cells, this is called as your inner nuclear layer. And this layer, which contains the cell bodies of the ganglion cells, this is called as the ganglion cell layer. And you can also make out from this that there are synapses. Where are the synapses? Have a look here. See, these photoreceptors are connecting to these bipolar cells by this synapse. So this, there is a layer of synapse here, and you can see that the bipolar cells are also connecting to the ganglion cells with the help of this synapse. So there is one synapse here. So what are these synapses called? This synapse between the photoreceptors and the bipolars, this layer, this is your outer plexiform layer. This is the outer plexiform layer, the synapse between the photoreceptors and bipolars. Likewise, this synapse between the bipolars and the ganglion cells, this is called as your inner plexiform layer. So this is how it is oriented. So we have the outer nuclear, then outer plexiform, the inner nuclear, then the inner plexiform, then we have the ganglion cell layers. And as I said, the axons of these ganglion cells, they are forming this nerve fiber layer. And this nerve fiber layers, see how it is eventually becoming the optic nerve and it is exiting the eye. So this is how the light is transmitted through the retina. So we get an idea about the different layers of the retina here. We understand that the layer that is closest to this choroid is actually the outermost layer. So this RPE is the outermost layer of the retina. Then we have the layer of the photoreceptors, which contains the outer part of the photoreceptor cells. The cell bodies of the photoreceptors are in the outer nuclear layer. The cell bodies of bipolar in the inner nuclear layer. The cell bodies of the ganglion cells in the ganglion cell layer. The synapses between photoreceptors and bipolar in the outer plexiform layer. The synapses between the bipolar and the ganglion cells in the inner plexiform layer. The nerve fiber layer is it contains the axons of these ganglion cells and eventually becomes your optic nerve. Now, the innermost layer of the retina, that is here, this layer which separates the retina from the vitreous, here, this would form your internal limiting membrane. So, that is the innermost layer, the layer of the retina that is just separating the retina from the vitreous. So, the outermost layer, the layer closest to the choroid is your RPE, and the innermost layer, that is the layer closest to the vitreous, that is your internal limiting membrane. Okay, so this model is just meant to give you an idea or an orientation of the different layers of the retina. To understand the theory properly, go through the first lecture that is there in retina, where I have discussed the anatomy of the retina, the blood supply of the retina. That will help you, and do go through the notes. That is going to help you understand the theory better. This 3D model I just wanted to keep so that students find it difficult to visualize which is the outer and which is the inner. So I hope this model has given you an idea that this is the outer part, which is the RPE is the outermost layer, and the internal limiting membrane, this is the innermost layer, which is closest to the vitreous. Right, now do go back to the section on retina and go through the lectures in detail. Thank you.